Looking for an all-in-one automated solution for managing your contacts across all of your apps and contact books? We recently had the chance to try out Clay, which is a CRM tool that works seamlessly for personal and business use. And what's even better is that they just launched an integration with Notion so you can keep track of birthdays, contact information updates, and more. In this video, we'll show you how to get started with Clay, top features, Notion integration use cases, and more. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. To get started with Clay, we first recommend you to go to their website and click the button Get Clay Free. And then what you'll want to do is create your Clay account. And once you go through the process of creating your account, you'll get to a point where they want you to connect at least one account to get started. So in this case, we're going to show you by connecting our Google account. And now it's asking whether or not you want to add both Google Calendar and Google Email. If you add your Google Calendar, it also shows you about previous meetings, which is quite useful as well. And now we can click continue. And here you can add your Clay profile. So if other people have Clay, then you're going to show up here with your unique name and email, Twitter, and so on. And then you have the chance to decide if you want your profile public or not. In this case, we're going to keep it off. And finally, you can also add your friends. Once you have loaded in your contacts from, for example, Google Calendar and Gmail, like we did, you'll notice that all of the people you've talked with on your Google account start showing up inside of Clay, which is really interesting and also really useful. So this happens in real time, so you don't have to keep adding people to your contacts, but Clay keeps track of them for you. So for example, if we go to this one, you'll notice that Leo was imported via email. You emailed Leo about the travel journal template on these days. And you can also see things like when you last chatted with them and how many times you did and how recently it was. So all of this is really useful for really keeping track of your contacts. And it also shows you how strong your network strength is, which can also be useful when you want to know how close you are to this person. If you also right click on this one, you can set a reconnect cadence. And what that does is it shows you how often Clay should recommend you to connect with them. So depending on how close you are with this contact, it could be weekly, monthly, quarterly, yearly, automatic that Clay intelligently decides, or you can disable it. The other interesting things you can do with Clay is that you can easily see some notices in your homepage. So you can see how many people have been added to Clay via email. You can discover some of the relationships that you have based on the information available in your contacts list. And during the day, you'll receive notices here, like when you should reconnect with a contact. Next, if we go to this button here, you can set up the settings. So if we go to settings, you can do a bunch of things with how you set things up, and you can check every single integration available on Clay. So for example, we have connected our Google. We also connected our Notion. So if you want to connect to Notion, it would be through here. There's also all these integrations possible that would also bring up real-time information based on how often you connect with these people. You can also adjust what kind of notifications you get, and weekly digest, daily brief, and so on. You can adjust the way that it looks, whether you want light mode or dark mode. And you can make sure to download it for iOS or Windows, depending on what you're using. And if you wanted to use this with more people, you can actually add members to this as well. So this is what makes Clay a really good tool, both for your personal use and for team use. The other things you can do is add groups. So let's say that you have a friends group. You can add a group for people here, and you can adjust the reconnect cadence depending on the group you have and adjust the colors. Down here, we also have this thing called Nexus, where you can use to ask different questions about your contact list, such as who do I know who speaks French, and really figure out who you have in your contacts list that you might want to connect with. Now let's try adding a new person by clicking plus new person. So let's say that we have a sample contact. And with this sample contact, since you added it manually, it shows an M sign. But if it was imported through email and other things, you'll see that based on where you imported this contact from. And you can see their about information here. And since it's empty right now, if we go up here and then we go to edit other details, we can add information such as their name, their bio, headline, their gender, for example, birthday. So let's just put a sample birthday here. And then you can also add their address. So let's say that they're in the United States, and you can add the location and click done. So now you'll see a bit more information like how old they are and their location. You can also go here and edit further details such as their social profiles. So you can put a sample website here and all of their social information. You can also go and add things like their organization. So if they belong to the Organized Notebook, LLC, and that's their current organization, you can add things like that and provide even more context about this person. And let's say that you met this person and you want to add a few notes, met this person at an event and it was a great conversation. You can add something like that. And this provides a great way to keep track of the people you meet. So now let's try this out inside of Notion. So we've already connected Notion, but if we go to the settings here and then we go to integrations, you can make sure that Notion is selected. Once you have it selected, it's going to take you through a process. And here you can start sharing access to Clay. So we're just going to go ahead and click next. And we would recommend you to choose use a template provided by the developer, allow access. Once you have Clay connected to your Notion, you should be redirected to this template that the developer created and basically allows you to access your Clay context database. So all you really need to do is connect it and then you should get a Clay context database like this. So here you'll see your Clay context database and inside here it's going to update based on the information that gets updated inside of Clay. So it's not a two-way sync, so make sure not to edit the content inside here directly, but rather through Clay. And the other thing you can do is look at it by gallery. For privacy reasons, we're not going to show the gallery. You can also see upcoming birthdays in a calendar view. You can also see the cities of your contacts, your closest relationships, and the most recent people you've contacted. So now if we go back to the main view here, you'll notice that Clay has already created a catalog of pre-configured views as well. So if we go to the Team CRM, you can use your contacts in this kind of CRM system where you can categorize the leads in contact negotiating, won and lost, and so on. So this is a way to use your database in order to track your contacts. Another way is as an address book, so you can see your information like this as well. And then inside here, you can see a birthday calendar. So now you might be wondering, in terms of use case, how can this be used? So the most useful way to use Clay could be that if you're already using your Notion as a way to store people, you can add additional information about that person by relating your database to the Clay contacts. So let's create an empty page so we can show you what this means. So we'll make something very simple, like a table view database. And let's say that we have a sample contact here. And then here you could put relation and then you can relate it to your Clay contacts and keep the show on Clay contacts off so that we don't manipulate the Clay contacts database and then add relation. And then now you can basically tag your contact with the correct person. So we have templates at makenotion.com. And if we click it open, now we can see all of the information about them, when you first contacted them, your contact strength and so on. And what's also interesting is that you can bring in more information using rollups. So if we click this plus button, rollups, and we wanted to select the Clay contacts, and then you can select which property you wanna see. So for example, you could choose the bio, your contact strength, and so on. And all of this gets updated in automatically based on what changes inside of Clay. So this can be a really nice way to keep an automated system of contact information that you can attach to any database that you might create inside of Notion. So we're really excited, for example, that we could potentially add this to our gift tracker and so on. So the use cases are really incredible in terms of adding further information that we couldn't previously, and seeing when we last contacted the person and so on. So you might be wondering, what are some of the limitations with this integration? So basically the two things that Clay has announced is that there is no two-way sync. So basically whatever Clay has is going to be synced into Notion. So be sure not to touch what goes into the Notion database for Clay. The other thing is updating existing databases. So you'll be using the Clay Contacts database as a starting point and customize from there. So be sure not to change the properties in there as well. So now you might be wondering, what is the pricing for Clay? So there is a free plan which gives you up to 1,000 contacts, and you basically get all of the features that you might need inside the free plan. So this is very generous. So we highly recommend you just to try it out and see if it works for you. Then there's also the Pro plan, which gives you one-on-one onboarding, priority support, and unlimited contacts. So again, this is really generous of them that they're really willing to help you one-on-one. So if you do go for the paid plans, it does seem like they're really willing to take care of you and make sure that you have the best possible experience with Clay. So there's also the team use and then enterprise as well. So here are final thoughts about Clay. So overall, we love the idea and vision behind Clay to manage your relationships in a single space. It's friendly to use and easy to connect to your apps like Gmail and Google Calendar. The integration just came out with Notion, so we're excited to see what kind of further features and improvements will come. Since there are no native tools inside Notion to truly keep track of your contacts, Clay is also able to fill in this gap, and we feel like the use cases and potential in this tool is really promising. Thank you so much for watching. We hope that this was interesting for you all. Be sure to try out Clay for free using the link in the description below. Have you tried Clay, and what are your initial thoughts? We'd love to hear from you, and we hope to see you all in the next video.